Just look at me as though you really saw me. Mom, 14 years have gone by. I'm dead. But you're a grandmother, Mama, and I'm married George Gibbs. Wally's dead too. His appendix burst on a camping trip to North Conway, and we felt just terrible about it, don't you remember? Just for a moment, we're happy. Just for a moment, we're together. Let's look at one another. It all goes so fast. There's no time to look at one another. So all that was going on, and we never noticed. Take me back up the hill to my grave. But first, wait. One more look. Goodbye. Goodbye, world. Goodbye, Grover's Corners. Mama. Papa. Goodbye, Clot Stain. And Mama's sunflowers, and new high-end dresses and hot baths, sleeping and waking up, food and coffee. Over. Oh, you're too wonderful for anyone to realize you. Do any human beings ever realize life while they live it? Every minute. No, the same as the poets do. So, I'm ready to go back. Were you happy? No, I should have listened to you. That's all you are, just blind people. You're just blind people. Look, the stars are coming out. They don't understand, do they? No, dear. They don't understand. Most everybody's asleep in Grover's Corners. Shorty Hawkins, down at the depot, just watched the Albany train go by. And down at the library stable, somebody's sitting up late and talking. Yes, there are the stars, doing their own crisscross journeys in the sky. Scholars haven't quite figured it out yet. But they seem to think that there are no living beings up there. Just chalk, or fire. Only this one is straining away. And the strain's so bad that every 16 hours, we all lie down